The second factor is the effect of pressure. The pressure of a system may be changed by changing the moles of reactant or product, changing the volume, or adding inert gas to the system. Affects only the reversible reaction involving gaseous reactants or gaseous products. We look at changing the moles of reactant or product. By adding or removing the gaseous reactant or product at constant volume, it gives the same effect as changing the concentration. For example, consider the following system at equilibrium. Sulfur dioxide reacts with oxygen in equilibrium with sulfur trioxide. When SO2 is added to the system, the partial pressure of SO2 will increase, meaning to say the concentration of SO2 increases. Then the position of equilibrium shifts to the right in order to reduce the effect of adding SO2 or in order to reduce the effect of high concentration of SO2. Now for the second subfactor, changes in volume. Please note that volume is inversely proportional to pressure. So when the volume increases, the position will shift in order or in direction to increase the number of moles, while if the volume is decreased, position will shift in the direction to decrease the number of moles. Now, for example, nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas in equilibrium with ammonia gas. Let's say the volume is decreased. This is external disturbance. When the volume is decreased, the position of equilibrium will shift in the direction to reduce the number of moles of gas particles. In this case, the right-hand side of the equation has two moles, while the left-hand side of the equation has 4 moles. So that means the equilibrium position will shift to right towards the lower number of moles. Now let's say we look at the third factor, changes in temperature. Increasing temperature favors the endothermic reaction, while decreasing the temperature favors the exothermic reaction. Kc and Kp changes in value as the temperature changes. For exothermic reaction, as given here, nitrogen gas reacts with hydrogen gas in equilibrium with ammonia gas. It is an exothermic reaction with the value of negative 92.83 kilojoule. Now let's say the temperature is increased, then the position of equilibrium will shift in the direction to decrease the heat supply. So now the equilibrium position will shift to the left in that direction to reduce or to decrease the heat supply. Similarly, if the temperature is decreased, then the equilibrium position will shift in the direction to increase the heat. And this time, the position of equilibrium will shift to the right to increase the heat or to release the heat. So if it shifts to the left-hand side of the equation, we can make conclusion. The ammonia gas in concentration will decrease. Hydrogen gas and nitrogen gas will increase. If the equilibrium position shift to the right, then concentration of nitrogen and hydrogen will decrease. Concentration of ammonia will increase. And then the value of KCKP, if the equilibrium shift to the left, will decrease, while if the equilibrium position shift to the right, the value of KPKC will increase. That is, if it's exothermic. Now we look at endothermic, where the forward reaction is positive value. If the temperature increases, then the equilibrium will shift in the direction to decrease the heat supply, so it will shift to the right. The equilibrium will shift to the right. That means what happened is the concentration of nitrogen and oxygen will decrease, while the concentration of nitrogen monoxide will increase. At the same time, the value of Kc and Kp will increase as well. If the temperature decreases, then the equilibrium position will shift in the direction to increase the heat, that is moving backward or to the left-hand side. In this case, concentration of nitrogen monoxide will decrease, while concentration of nitrogen and oxygen will increase. At this time, the value of Kc and Kp will decrease. Increasing temperature favors endothermic and decreasing temperature favors exothermic. Adding heat, for example, heating the vessel, favors away from the increase. Adding heat favors the reverse reaction. Removing heat or cooling favors the forward reaction. Now we look at a graph, exercise question. The graph below shows the percentage of carbon at 100 Kelvin and 200 Kelvin for a reaction. Write the equilibrium constant expression Kp for the reaction. Please take note, this is a homogeneous system because all the phase are same. Based on the graph, explain whether forward tap reaction is endothermic or exothermic. Explain whether the value of Kp is high at 100 Kelvin or 200 Kelvin. So we look at the solution. The solution is not provided here. We will discuss this one during our tutorial class. Please remind me in our tutorial class.